Welcome.
Welcome.
To the celebrated nightly news of Calaveras County. And we're back in the cozy confines of the studio.
Yes, we are. Because on Tuesday night, we were out and about.
Yes.
On a remote.
A remote, yes. Until they started the microwave oven.
That's right. Yeah. There we were like not so remote. Yeah. We were just dead, actually. Yes.
It was like, oh, no. We're going to...
And I was told we looked like Northern Irish picks last night,
yes,
too.
We had a little bluish tint. Yes. So,
we were slightly blue.
We know that since we're doing this, is a remote pushing into the studio. We don't always look studio quality, but last night was especially not...
Especially not studio quality. Maybe we'll take on a greenish tinge for Murphy's Irish Days.
A greenish tinge,
that would be something to tune in for. Definitely.
Hey,
I was thinking of some appropriate
huh?
day that, you know, we could have said Monday or Tuesday night we turned blue for, but I can't think of any blue holidays. Can you?
We just turned blue.
No, we were just blue.
Yeah, we just turned blue, and it was just blue.
Just blue. Yes.
Yeah.
That's the news of the day. We were blue.
We were blue. Anyway. All right.
Yeah.
Well, we thank you for stopping by. Mm-hmm. We really do. We know you have lots of choices for news, and
yes.
I just, you know, and we're glad that you stopped by here because, mm-hmm. you know, as we inch up on those Katie Couric.
That's right. She's
just
sliding
kidding.
Down. We're
just
sliding
kidding.
Up. We're crawling our way up should be the appropriate descriptive.
Yes. Now, also just want to remind you that starting tomorrow night, we will be broadcasting Bret Hart football. So we're going to push out Bret Hart football. You should see
Friday
it.
Night.
Oh, Friday
yes.
night, not Thursday night.
Yes.
Friday night.
Did you
so you
see
should...
my confusion?
Yeah, she's like, he's a moron
wait,
again.
What?
Yeah,
well,
he's lost
it. I thought it was Friday.
Yeah. But we'll start doing that. So that would so look for that on Channel 7. I think mm-hmm. it should be kind of fun. And also
really
on thepinetree.net.
Yes.
So if you have friends, family, relatives that would like to watch the athletes up and down the field,
right.
you should be able to do it from anywhere on the planet.
Mm-hmm.
So.
That's right.
Yeah.
Anywhere on the planet.
Of course, you have to have an internet connection.
Exactly.
Or local Comcast, but it should be kind of fun.
Yeah, one or the other.
Now, we'll have
to
look at, I don't know if this is the first time they've done live on cable or not, but it can't be too many.
They've done some live broadcasts, but not games. I don't believe they've ever broadcast any games live. I'm not sure on that. They may have tried to.
Maybe somebody brought a crew in from out of town or something like that.
They do have a live pipe going into the cable studios, but I don't know if they've actually broadcast games live.
Yeah.
So this will be the first time that
we
know of. So it should be a very cool thing.
Now, we spent this morning at a meeting up at Lake Alpine, where it was the Bear Valley Business Association meeting this morning. We were there on other issues, but kind of the fun thing was one of the topics of was the Ebbets Pass Scenic Byway Celebration. And the whole corridor.
This weekend.
Yes, the whole corridor is really getting energized for this. It's from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m., running from Arnold all the way over to Markleyville.
Yes.
And they're going to have basically live music all the way along across. They were going to be out there Friday night setting up all their booths, all
That's
their tents.
Right.
They're going to provide you free lunch at Bear Valley.
Nice.
Free lunch.
What are they serving?
Well, hot dogs and stuff, but they're going to be free.
Wow.
So
I wish I'd signed up for traffic school on a different day.
Yeah.
notice how
so
you
it's
say
gonna be...
I notice how I didn't say I wish I never sped at all.
Yes. You just yes. Well, anyway, and we'll go through some of these now. This is we're going through this. I know tomorrow night's our tell you what to do
exactly.
thing, but I think if
but
you're looking for this weekend,
early.
This is a little early. Just kind of give you a heads up on what's going on. Starting in Arnold at 794 Highway 4 at Serafina's and Camp Comforts. This is also Sid Marsh's house there,
yes,
right there. So.
Yes.
They'll be having a two-person bucksaw and Sierra Nevada Logging Museum demonstration. So they're going to have booths there. The Arnold Art Fest, the Chainsaw Bear demonstration, information booth from Ebbets Pass Forest Watch, and Sierra Nevada Adventure Company. Snack will also have a booth there.
Oh, very nice.
And we're probably going to have a live webcam set up for there. So if you want to watch this particular one all day long...
Yes, you can.
So if you... can't make it to the festivities.
Mm-hmm. Or and have access to a computer, which I don't think they'll let me go online either.
Probably not. And also, just up the road at Calaveras Big Trees State Park, they're going to have at 10 a.m. the Junior Rangers, ages 7 to 12, and Junior Cubs, and meet behind the Visitor Center for an hour. Mm-hmm. 10 to have informal interpretive programs, displays on the Big Stump. The Big
yes.
Stump. And information table at the Campfire Center. And at, at 10, 11, noon, 2, 3, and 4, they'll have a 30-minute guided walk and introduction to the North Grove.
Oh, how nice.
So that way, and at 1 and 2 p.m., they're going to have a two-hour guided walk of the North Grove of Giant Sierras. So you can have a two-hour guided tour. So,
wow.
Yeah, so that's at Big Trees. Now on up to the Dorrington Hotel. They're going to have the Lube Room, Station and Grill for lunch at 11:30. Local Artisans Fair. They're going to have a pictorial history display. And the Dorrington muzzle loaders with black powder, axe, and knife throwing demos.
Knife throwing.
So don't tick them off, because otherwise they may throw them
at you
instead of just
demonstrating for you.
Yeah. And live music begins at 4 p.m. at the Dorrington Hotel at the Camp Connell General Store, just a hop, skip, and a jump up Highway 4. From 10 a.m. to 1 p.m., they're going to have brunch by San Antonio Creek. Then they're going to have live music featuring Blue Shoes, historic photos, nature photography exhibit, and painting exhibit by Nancy May Cumber.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Wow.
They're at the Camp Connell General Store. See?
You're not even up to Bear Valley yet.
You're not even up to Bear Valley. All right. Then on up to Bear Valley. At the south parking lot, right off of Bear Valley Road, that from 12 to 4 p.m., they're going to have live music. Mm-hmm. They're going to have frisbee golf tournaments. And for those of you that didn't know, they now have a 9-hole frisbee golf course set up there mm-hmm. in Bear Valley. It's free. You can go up there and
very nice.
Frisbee golf. And they're going to have a barbecue lunch, guided mountain bike tours,
free
access to the Ebbets Pass Historical Association Museum,
mm-hmm.
historic photos by Tom O'Neill, and the Lake Alpine, and that's the Bear Valley Village.
Yes.
A couple miles up the road, the Lake Alpine Resort, live music, restaurant open for lunch from 1 to 3, dinner mm-hmm. from 5 to 9.
Okay.
Grocery store from open to 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. Okay, wood carving by Miles Tucker. Bear Valley Adventure Company is going to have a booth there as well. The Bear Valley Snowmobile will have a booth there at Lake Alpine Resort. And the local artists will have a display there as well. And while we're on Lake Alpine...
What's local? Who are the local artists?
It doesn't say. It's just
generic
local
artists.
Oh, it's just
local.
Yeah.
Okay, just generic.
But one of the things that they're going to do with Lake Alpine this year, and this is something we talked about this morning, is the new owners are going to open Lake Alpine Lodge all year round. They've ordered snowcats.
See, this is very nice.
But they're going to start taking people.
One of those rumors that was out. And go ahead.
Yeah, but they're going to, so that way they've ordered snowcats and stuff. So during the winter, let's say you went up there and you didn't have a snowmobile, or you just wanted to go have a roll. They will pick you up out there at the road closure, take you back on snow. You can have a romantic dinner in there by the firelight in the snow, if you like snow.
If you like snow. That's the caveat.
And believe it or not, a lot of people actually do.
They do.
And also, since they're going to try to... Because if you look at a lot of places on the East Coast, the snowmobiling is a whole life unto itself.
Yes,
they'll
it is.
Go you know, miles out and have whole restaurants and basically towns are supported
by snowmobiling.
Yes. So hopefully we can build a little bit of that ecosystem
here.
Yeah.
That'd be very cool.
And also on up the hill too,
Hermit Valley.
Live music by Bill Wells and Shiraz with Ron Shaner and Aaron Ross, plus a special guest from noon to 5 p.m. The U.S. Forest Service interpretive talks, and I believe Lonnie Allison is going to be up there on that one. McCollumy, and also going to have the McCollumy Coast to Crest Trail information at Hermit Valley.
Okay. And
all the way over to Markleeville, the Alpine County Museum on School Street in Markleeville. And they're going to have complimentary entrance to the Alpine County Museum, so they're not going to charge you if you want to go in. Music provided by the Alpine Trio. Art demonstrations by Markleeville artists.
Ah.
Uh-huh. Arts and crafts available for purchase. Free Alpine County visitor guides and county map. And from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m., Indian tacos prepared by Dale Bennett.
Ooh, very good.
Now, this is one of those things This I know I'm running a little bit long on this, but you got
the inaugural. Yeah,
this is the inaugural, the first annual.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. See, because you're going to be issued a passport.
Mm-hmm.
And if you get your passport stamped at all the different spots,
mm-hmm.
you're eligible for fabulous prizes. Yes.
Oh.
Yes, here we go. A 2007-2008 seasons pass to Bear Valley Mountain Resort, a $500 value.
Wow.
A midweek mini ski vacation at Bear Valley Lodge includes a two-night stay, 4 lift tickets, and a $75 gift certificate for dinner at the lodge's Creekside Dining Room. $500 value. An overnight stay with 2 dinners at the Dorrington Hotel, $250 value. A $100 gift certificate from the Camp Connell General Store. A $100 gift certificate from Two Rivers Trading Company in Arnold.
Mm-hmm.
And 2 $50 gift certificates to the Lake Alpine Lodge. And a $25 gift certificate to Serafina's in Arnold.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah.
So you have to get all of your passport stamped
correct.
Across the hill.
Correct.
Okay, to
and
qualify
there's 8 of
for those.
And if you're so inclined to volunteer,
mm-hmm.
they're still looking for people to manage, you know, to
man
a couple
the
of booths. The booths. Yeah. Call Marsha Larrabee at 795-9942 or email her at mlarrabee@comcast.net.
Okay.
So,
well,
here you go.
That should be something this weekend.
There's a lot of people really excited.
I can see why.
So I guess I'll be quiet since I talked virtually nonstop for 10 minutes.
That's okay.
I was a mic hog.
You were a mic hog?
Yes.
Oh, it sounded like my cog.
My cog.
And there's a Wednesday night cog meeting
yes.
tonight, actually. But I don't have the page up to tell you about it. Do you have that page up?
The cog meeting. Let's see. We have a photography exhibit up.
Yes, we do.
Yes, we do.
Well, he's talking about that, I just wanted to talk about a couple of CHP incidents that have been reported today. One is a non-injury collision at Armstrong Road and Sheep Ranch Road. And that happened today about 11:17. About 10:30, 11 this morning. It's cleared, obviously. And also, we have cows again. There are
no
two
way.
Cows in the road. You know, this is a big season for motorcycles and cows this summer. So CHP is repeating 2 more loose cows on the road at Michael Road and Mountain Ranch Road, and this was yesterday, and hopefully they cleared those cows out. That was about 8 o'clock p.m. So those are the CHP.
CHP stuff?
CHP stuff. There was a collision, actually, yesterday, Highway 49 and Gold Strike Road, and obviously they cleared the scene, and it was... no fatalities or anything like that. So
and
anyway,
the Calaveras County Council of Governments, or the COG, is meeting tonight at 6:30 in the Board of Supervisors chambers in San Andreas.
Mm-hmm.
And they have... Now, this is the thing we talked about last night, is they're getting ready to start digging dirt on the bypass.
That's right.
The
they're
21st
going out there with their
PM.
Shovels, and this is, like you said... the first bond measure bypass in the state.
Yeah.
But because we are Calaveras County and not San Diego County, we have to not have the big hoopy that San
yes.
Diego is having.
I know. So, anyway, for their consent agenda, it's basically state highway projects, more
mm-hmm.
on the wagon. Now, fill me in on the wagon trail realignment.
The wagon trail realignment, it used to go down Highway 4.
Okay.
So they would have to close off one side and
if
then the other.
If they have a wagon trail
When
thing?
The wagon trail. Because every annually the wagon trail comes in and people
okay.
are in their wagons and they're all dressed in their reenactment and they take the wagon trail.
As opposed to the SUV?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
All right.
It's all horse and buggy. And my understanding is that there's some issue with them going on Highway 4 through Angel's Camp, and they're trying to realign
the wagon trip.
A different arena. I don't know where they will realign them to. That has yet to be determined, but I know that... I don't know if the general public is upset about them coming through town, but I know Caltrans is. Because
Caltrans, they tend to get upset.
Well, they were upset when the... those the players that would come out in Angels Camp a few years ago and do the shootout reenactments down in downtown Angels. They did that, and people loved it on
so you
the weekends.
Can not
and
have
Caltrans
killing or
made,
otherwise
that's
on
right.
a public highway.
Caltrans said, no way, it holds up traffic. Which
but you
it
can
did,
do it
but
state
it was
park.
Kinda cool. Yes, but you can do it in a state park.
So
yeah, so that's what the wagon trail wheel what was it?
Wagon trail realignment.
Yes.
Okay. Also the Angels Camp bypass is on the agenda, of course.
Of course. I wonder how many officials and dignitaries will show up.
I bet they'll just show up. This is kind of a big deal.
I wonder if it'll be local or the state guys.
Well, all the local ones will probably show up.
Mm-hmm. But I wonder if the state guys will come up.
I hope so.
I hope so, too.
And one of the things we better mention a little bit, because if you weren't watching the news last night, the groundbreaking for the Angels Camp bypass is going to be the 21st at 1 p.m.
Yes.
And this is the first mm-hmm.
in the state.
Bond-funded.
That's
Caltrans
what I meant by
project.
Bonded.
Okay. Caltrans-funded project.
Exactly.
Now, and we should be able to crow a little bit about this, because
yes,
this is
exactly.
a milestone.
This is
but
a big thing.
I guess that there's going to be another one in San Diego that the groundbreaking is going to be on October 5th.
And that's bond funded as well.
Yes.
They're
and
a larger media market than we are.
They are a major media market, and we are a micro media market.
Micro.
Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger decided to not attend our humble groundbreaking here.
Micro media.
But to yeah. attend the one in San Diego.
That's right. More cameras.
More cameras, more people.
More people.
So.
I bet there's no web cams like you would
probably
provide.
Not. Yeah, they wouldn't. Yeah, so it's. But, so they have.
And apparently he has said that he doesn't want state officials there either. Like
this is
the
what
Caltrans,
we heard off the record.
This
we're not sure. This
record,
is kind of
a little scuttlebutt
behind the
that
the
we
scenes.
Weren't able to confirm. Of course, you will not ever be able to confirm something like that.
Yes.
But apparently he does not want like the Caltrans officials there and the other big public officials from the state, which is. Why I was kind of curious as whether our state
so
legislative
we're going
people
to
would be
do
there.
Our best to make sure that you know
yes.
that Calaveras County and the Angels Camp bypass
that's right
was first
the first
was first
yes the first the absolute first but you wouldn't know it from the state
no you would they'll never tell you
no.
That's now, if you haven't seen on our website, thepinetree.net, is we have some weekly columnists.
Yes.
We do. And one is on dating. And this one is, this week's is The Garden of Relationships by Karen Wildwood. And there's even a comment
a
on
comment.
It.
A comment.
So if you want to watch, if you want to look at some good commentary, some good mm-hmm. columns, we have those on there. So
there's quite a few. There's Ken Churches as well.
Yes.
He provides a column.
Mm-hmm.
And
that's a very
can,
pretty fall picture.
That is. You can comment on his columns as well. And we ready to go to state news? Besides our little bond-funded bypass.
And if you want, we can touch, if we have time, we'll touch on some of the area fires, too, because it's still pretty
okay.
smoky out there.
It's pretty smoky.
Let's see. Let's look at the Plumas County, the Moonlight Fire. The Moonlight Fire now, and this is where some of the smoke is coming
yes.
down from that one,
mm-hmm.
is 64,000 acres, and it's 58% contained,
mm-hmm.
and they're pretty conservative. So if they are saying 58, they're getting
more.
Pretty close. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
2,500 residences threatened. There's two residences, one out building have been destroyed, but they basically,
mm-hmm.
they got that one. And the other one is the Lick Fire. The
yes.
Lick Fire is the one from Santa Clara that actually caused the mood change the venue from Bret Hart.
Mm-hmm.
They are official, as of yesterday, 100% contained. It
very
ended up
nice.
Being 47,760 acres.
Mm-hmm.
Four residences and 20 outbuildings destroyed. Wow, more stuff than I had thought. 9 injuries, and it was human caused. And the cost
okay.
of fighting it was $10.2 million.
Isn't Isn't that amazing how much it costs?
Yeah.
And this legislative session officially ends on Friday, and I just wanted to read a couple of headlines. He laughs at me. Governor vetoes bid to put Iraq issue on state ballot. Shortly before midnight Tuesday, Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger vetoed legislation that would have made California the first state to vote on whether President Bush should immediately withdraw troops from Iraq. Which is sort of an interesting one. And this actually, these are supposedly headed to the California ballot. Healthcare, water issues probably headed to California ballot. Voters may be asked next year to approve funding elements of a healthcare overhaul and water storage expansion, because we do have water storage issues in the state, under a plan outlined Tuesday by legislative leaders and Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger. With the regular legislative session set to end Friday, Schwarzenegger called lawmakers into a special session to deal with water and healthcare, a session that began on Tuesday night. And this is actually really interesting, and I'm sure that restaurants are not going to be very happy about this one. Restaurants may be forced to serve up nutritional data. Not all Californians follow their calorie count, but in 2 years, calorie counts may follow Californians when they go out to eat. The State Assembly approved a measure this week that would require restaurant and fast food chains to display the nutritional information of all items on their menus.
On the menu, not
on the menu.
Someplace
My
on
understanding
the wall,
is that it's
menu.
On the menu.
Oh, what a mess.
So, let me just go ahead and...
A couple little national news little bits is one thing is and I know if you're planning for later in your life, this is if we assume they get that immortality thing figured out, the Earth may survive the sun's demise in 5 billion years.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I didn't hear
so
that.
That's
big news.
It is. So I was...
That's big news.
Just so, anyway.
Because according to one of the latest Doctor Who episodes of the new Doctor
yes.
Who. Well, the semi-new Doctor Who. This was the Doctor Who that was new a couple years ago. Aliens were going to pay good money to see the sun blow up and the Earth get destroyed.
Interesting.
Good
so that
money.
Was it was going to be a spectator sport?
A spectator sport, absolutely.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oil also hit $80 a barrel for the
yes.
first time. So, $80 a barrel. But then the good news, life expectancy for Americans hit 78 years.
Really?
So that is not bad.
Wow.
Yeah. And
click.
And the world's smallest four-seater has been unveiled, a tiny Toyota.
Well, that's kind of cool.
Yeah. And also on the and you may have seen this on the news because it's making the rounds on the talk shows and everything else. in Yovanovstok. Oh, Ulyanovsk, Russia. The governor of Central Russia province urged couples to skip work on Wednesday and make love instead of working to help boost Russia's low birth weight. And if a woman gives birth to in exactly 9 months' time on Russia's National Day of June 12, she will qualify for a prize or perhaps even winning a new home.
Really?
Now they've been running. They've been running these little things over there in Russia repeatedly. So they're trying to get people to
procreate.
So state sanctioned procreation.
Well, isn't the United States birth rate been down for quite a few years now too?
I would assume so.
It is.
Yeah.
Yes, compared to other countries, we don't have a lot of babies either.
And the election stuff is getting a little bit snippy.
It's getting snippy.
Rudy
and
Hillary are going
time.
At each other.
Yeah, it's not even time for it to get snippy yet.
And if you're a Hillary fan, this whole fundraising thing will not go away anytime soon.
Because
they're going to try to drag the stuff from the previous administration, her husband's administration into it. This thing will be...
It will be around for a while.
It will be around for the for a while. Mm-hmm. So it's like, what did you get with your 850 grand? Didn't get anything.
I think it might be weather time.
I think so.
Weather.
Weather. The world's
weather.
Smallest four-seater. The IQ prototype is just nine. I'm still back on the smallest, world's smallest four-seater on the Toyota.
Is.
9 feet, 9 inches long.
Which is
about 3 inches shorter than the first Mini.
Really?
Yes, that's tiny.
So that kind of gives you a perspective.
Yes. And it even comes with a swimsuit model. Oh, wait, that's just the promo.
And she's not even in a swimsuit. I tell you, you know, he couldn't wait to get the belly dancing picture up on the screen.
I know. It's time. It's definitely time for weather.
Time for weather. The heat is getting
to
him.
Yeah, and it's starting
to
rain.
And it's not even as hot as it used to be.
No.
Let's see. All right, let's get this here. Arnold Weather.
Arnold Weather.
There we go.
And I'll pull up Bangor.
Thursday, high of 75 degrees, sunny. Friday, high of 74 degrees and sunny. And Saturday, a high of 76 degrees and sunny.
For our friends all the way across the U.S. in Bangor, Maine.
Bangor,
we have
Maine.
72 degrees and 42.
We're still waiting for our lobster, too.
I know. 72 degrees, high of 42 is a low. 67 and 40.
Mm-hmm.
40. Thursday night. Bit chilly.
That's a little
Friday,
low.
They have 72 as a high and 50 as a low and 66 and 44 for Bangor, Maine.
For Bangor, Maine. And here in Bear Valley, Thursday a high of 71 degrees, Friday a high of 67 degrees, and Saturday a high of 68 degrees. So as you go over the pass, you might want to take a little sweater if you get a little chilly. Murphy's weather, Thursday 82 degrees, Friday a high of 77 degrees, and Saturday, a high of 84 degrees. And all those days are going to be sunny.
Copperopolis is 88 tomorrow, or for today.
Mm-hmm.
Thursday, a down to a very pleasant 82 degrees with a, or actually 28 degrees Celsius high. If you want to, should we start reporting
be
weather
Euro,
in Celsius?
If we want to be Euro.
79 degrees is the high on Friday and 81 on Saturday. Just perfect weather.
Perfect.
Just
perfect.
Perfect.
And Angels Camp, not much different actually. Thursday, sunny with a high of 81 degrees. Friday, sunny with a high of 76 degrees. And Saturday, sunny with a high of 80 degrees. And did you get Valley Springs weather?
I got Copperopolis. I can do Valley Springs here real quick.
Okay, let's do Valley Springs.
And all right, 88 degrees is a high today. 81 tomorrow, 77 on Friday, and 80 on Saturday. Just perfect weather.
Perfect weather.
We don't want to jinx it, but boy, if we can keep weather like this, it'll sure help us get through the rest of this fire season.
Yeah, well,
you know,
definitely. Definitely. And the firefighters are out there working hard on a lot.
Yeah, a lot of stuff. And they've done yeoman's job this around this area. They've just
absolutely
pounced on stuff
absolutely.
And just absolutely have done a phenomenal job.
Mm-hmm.
And we thank you.
Yes, for joining us here again, and hope to see you again tomorrow
on the
night.
PineTree.net and also Channel 7.
That's right.
And we will be back tomorrow night
to tell you what to do.
And remember, our news broadcast may be preempted on the 10 o'clock showing on, we should have both of them. For
should
football,
have.
We should, so it should be all, you're probably going to see us on news, then we're going to go to football.
That's right,
back.
You'll see us again.
So you'll see us again. Good night.
Good night.